Good evening and welcome to Harris Stadium. I'm Joe Vicioni with
Robert Paris.
As the Burlington Red Devils are set to take off against the Belmont Maurauders here in Belmont, Massachusetts. Last game, Burlington won an astounding 34-12 over the Salem Witches, which was a blowout for them. Winning their last three games, a big W here would mean that the Devils could go 5-5 on the season. On the other end of the field, the Belmont Maurauders lost their last game by 7 points to rival Waltham, as they will have much to prove. The Maurauders are also 0-5 on the season away, but 3-1 at home, so hopefully they should make a tough-fought battle. Robert, what did you think about last game for the Red Devils?
Well, I thought it was great scoring, Joe. Bonfilly had some great speed. The defense was really well. I want to see what they can try to do today.
And Robert, what's your score prediction for today's game?
Well, Joe, I'm going to have to tell you. 20-0.
20-0. That's a pretty astounding victory for one side, Robert.
Well, I got a tally for you.
So you're Burlington coming out on top with this game?
Absolutely.
So Robert being very confident for tonight's game, on myself, I'll take it 21-7. An easy score for the Red Devils to walk away with a loss for an away game. It will be unfortunate, but I'm not sure if the Devils can keep up with the Maurauders at home. We'll see you at the start of the game. Thank you. Welcome to Harris Field in lovely Belmont, Massachusetts. I'm Joe Vicioni with...
I'm Robert Paris.
As the Burlington Red Devils are set to take on the Belmont Maurauders in this highly coveted game. The Red Devils coming into this with three straight wins. One of which were at home. Last game, the Red Devils took a 34-12 win against the Salem Witches, and in that game, Burlington had much to prove as the Maurauders start this game with a squib kick over to Zachary Sear, I believe. No, Kyle Forster, as Forster picks up space, avoids the tackle, and is brought down just short of the 50-yard line, about the 46. So Burlington already with a great special team possession. But Robert, earlier in this game, you said that the Red Devils were going to come away with a 20-0 victory, which is quite a lot. You regret that at all yet?
Exactly. I believe, because that was a really nice run, I believe everything, and here we go.
As the Devils could open up on this drive, notable players on this offense, Zachary Sear, a running back who's fantastic, and you should know much of him this year. Dylan Bonfilio, the quarterback and senior, who is just fantastic, who had a great passing game against Salem, where they had no pass rush. Let's see how the offensive line for the Devils hold out tonight. High snap to Bonfilio, takes it up the middle, but is stuffed and brought down by number 45.
That was a really hard hit, Joe, don't you agree?
That was Adam Deese. It was I wouldn't say a hard hit, but he was just brought down. It was nearly a butt fumble-esque and football-like, if you remember that, with Mark Sanchez against the Patriots. He hit his own lineman and went down. It seems like Bonfilio had a bit of miscommunication and just falls down as they lose a couple yards, maybe two. Bonfilio under center has Zach Sear as he swings it over to Sear on the right side, who takes it outside, shovels down as he picks up no yards on the carry, which brings up a third down for the Devils.
This is a tough third down, Joe, because if they don't convert now, they're gonna have to punt it. And with that, let's see what the Red Devils can do.
As the Devils have the ball slightly towards the right side of the field, the Devils don't want to go on a three and out for the first possession of the game, as Bonfilio has it lined up in the trips. The receivers to the left, looking, has time, and airmails a pass for Lamine, as Lamine catches it, and he is in for the touchdown for the Red Devils. Burlington Got a bit unfortunate with their first couple plays, but gets in for a touchdown, courtesy of Dylan Bonfilio and the senior to number 7, Gianni Newman. So the Red Devils pick up a score just a minute in, making Robert's pick look pretty knowledgeable already.
Joe, that was a great drive, because on a third down like that, you never know what could happen.
Interesting formation for the Red Devils. Bit of a tricky play here as they fake it. A beautiful fake play in the end zone. Wow, wow. I do not believe what I just saw.
Joe, I've never seen a play like that ever.
As 8 linemen were lined up on the left side, as the ball was snapped to a lineman, and as he took it in, I believe that was Luke Lord who got the 2-point conversion, making it 8-0 for the Red Devils. Just about a minute 30 into the game, so the Devils already with an 8-0 lead over the Marauders. Now we'll see how the Red Devils' defense can hold up, and they are certainly known for providing big firepower on that end. Well, we have notable players as Kyle Forrester. We saw Forrester on the return earlier. He's also a great linebacker, along with Zachary Sear. Both players, running backs, halfbacks, that provide a lot of depth to this squad. Alec Rollins, who is a junior, not seeing too much time. Not sure why he hasn't been playing, as he has not started since the Wilmington game. Also on the team, a great player on the defense for the Red Devils is Billy Pappas. How can you forget him? Fantastic linebackers. The Devils are stacked up at that position. Michael Pavo being a cornerback as the kick is up, fielded as the Marauders takes it to about the just short of the 30-yard line.
Well, I got to tell you, Joe, that drive right there, that kickoff, let's see what the defense can do.
As the Marauders have the ball on the 29-yard line. Snap is given straight up the middle as he is brought down by a combination of Burlington players. Tackle most likely credited to Zachary Sear, as the Devils stop the Marauders as they pick up about 1 yard on the carry. As the Marauders send an offensive lineman off the field to maybe switch out for a wide receiver, as we could see them airing out a pass, maybe. Belmont with the ball under center as the quarterback, as he fakes the handoff, going for a pass, looking deep, as it is caught by the Marauders in coverage by Hakeem Anajarian, as he is wrapped up and brought down within the 20-yard line.
That was an amazing play, Joe. I just love seeing that. It's just...
As the Devils cannot do anything on that play, it looks like they were confused by the play action, but they nearly got to the quarterback. But Hakeem Anajarian looks like he thought the ball was going a bit shorter as he tried to intercept it, but it just goes past him. And that's a first down for the Marauders, putting them in pretty dangerous territory, Robert.
Yeah, the Devils are in really dangerous territory, Joe. I'm kind of nervous right now.
As a handoff is given straight up the middle, as it looks like he picks up 2 yards on the carry. As that was Cal Cristofori on quarterback for the Marauders. As it's going to be 2nd and 5 for the Marauders. Cristofori lined up in the I formation. As he takes it, him as the fullback dive, takes it himself, as it looks like he'll pick up a few yards on that carry. Forrester with the tackle.
Joe, it is now 3rd and 5. This is a critical 3rd down for the Red Devils.
Another I formation lined up here as it's a 3rd and 1 for Belmont. Cristofori takes it, gives the handoff to 14 as he escapes pressure and is in for the touchdown as the Marauders equal the score in 3 plays. Both teams scoring on their 3rd down conversion as it will be 8-6 in favor of the Red Devils as this will bring up an extra point for the Marauders. As it's going to be an extra point right now, as the quarterback, Cristofori, is set to hold it, and the kick is up, and it nails straight through the uprights, as that gives the Red Devils an 8-7 lead over Belmont High School, both teams scoring on their first drives of the game. As we'll see how Burlington's offense can do on this next play, as I'm expecting much out of this game. Robert, seems like your prediction is wrong already.
Unfortunately, yes, Joe. I think that play, the Devils should have done a 3-deep blitz. That was my thing. They should have done that.
Red Devils are getting set to receive on the kick. Number 3 set to kick off, Aiden Catagon. Zachary Sear, and I believe that's Forrester, and Julian Otavo in the backfield. As it's a squib kick, short over to Forrester, as Forrester gets to about the 46-yard line for the 2nd time of the night. As the Red Devils will have a great field position again on roughly the 47-yard line. So already getting in near attacking zone, Robert.
Joe, I was actually surprised with that squib kick on the kickoff. I'm surprised they didn't kick it deep. And why do you think, what was the purpose of that?
As Burlington lined up in the trips formation, 3 receivers on the left, screen pass over to Sear, as Sear picks up about 5 yards on the catch. As it's going to be a 2nd and 5 for the Red Devils, as they are in the Marauders' territory for the 2nd time of the night. Burlington trying to rack up a 2nd touchdown on the board, as they're currently leading 8-7. Over the Belmont Marauders. Marauders in maroon tonight as the Red Devils are in white and red. Bonfilio, 2 receivers to the right, 1 to the left. As he takes it himself on the keeper play, and Bonfilio is tackled, but he will pick up the 1st down for the Red Devils.
Joe, we all know.
As Belmont's defense did not see that one coming, I have a feeling that they were expecting a handoff given to who else but Zachary Sear. We see Billy Pappas coming in right now on the left side, lined up in the trips formation for the 3rd time in the night, as he could be a threat as a wide receiver, as he's known for those short little routes, almost like a Julian Edelman, as we could see him manufacturing lots of minutes here. As Bonfilio takes it, a little screen pass to Sear, as Sear escapes on the right side and is tackled out of bounds at the 30-yard line for a 1st down.
Now that faked really worked for perfection there, Joe. I really like what they did. Let's see what they can do.
As the Red Devils have it on the 29-yard line after 2 great plays. A fantastic kickoff return by Kyle Forrester for the 2nd time of the night. Puts Burlington in good field position. Bonfilio takes it on the keeper play again, and he takes a big hit but is brought down for about 4 or 5 yards maybe on the carry. Bonfilio already, Robert, showing his scrambling skills out of the pocket.
That's what I predicted, Joe. I mean, like, he did it the last game in Salem, and now he's doing it again. Let's see if he can increase his percentage between the last game and Salem.
Now, Bonfilio is an interesting specimen at quarterback because he can throw in the pocket, he can scramble around, but he's more of a run-and-gun type of guy as he is brought down this time by 46 on the by the Marauders, as no one's too happy with that play. As we can hear the coaches from here upset, as it's going to bring up a third down and about nine for the Red Devils and this offense. Back to Bonfilio. He is a rare specimen, as he's fantastic at scrambling, and we've seen already about three plays where he's run it himself and picked up a first down or maybe even more yards. But he's also a great pocket passer, as we saw last game in Salem, so sure to be in store for great here. Snap is low. Bonfilio looks in the end zone as it is batted down on a low pass by Dylan Bonfilio, as his passing skills did not carry over from last game, at least on that play, as it brings up a fourth down, as the Red Devils will go for it on fourth and eight.
Critical fourth and eighth, Joe. I'm really excited to see what the Red Devils can do. Let's see if the offensive line can do it.
Now, the Red Devils are easily going for this on fourth down, as their kicking has not been fantastic, as we've seen inconsistency from the kicker, Fernando Amin. Bonfilio takes it as he's pressured and the offensive line collapses. He throws it in the end zone for Sear as it goes right through his hands. Incomplete pass as the Marauders will take over for a turnover on downs.
Unfortunately, the play didn't develop. Sorry to say, but it just wasn't a good fourth and eight.
So the Red Devils have to defend right here after a first down play by the Marauders. They picked up about 8 yards, I believe, on the carry. Cristoforo in the pocket, commanding two receivers to the right, set up in the I formation. Takes the handoff as it's given straight up the middle. Brought down for a loss of a yard or so. Bringing up a third and five for the Marauders. So Belmont in another third down situation, but Robert, hopefully we don't see the Burlington defense collapse yet again, as it was a third down last time where the Marauders got a miraculous catch, ultimately leading to a touchdown on Burlington territory.
Well, Joe, they got to step up. They can't be fooling around. They got to step up.
And I'll tell you, they stepped up right there as the Red Devils stopped them, as it's going to be a fourth down, forcing Belmont to punt. It looks like we're gonna have Hakeem Anajarian in the backfield. Cody Davidson with the tackle. So we have Zachary Sear in the backfield with Julian Otavo set to return this one. And Ajirian, excuse me, in the backfield. We haven't seen too much of him, except for his blown coverage earlier, as the kick is high and up to Ajirian as it wails over his head as he takes it at about the 35-yard line and is hit out of bounds at the 34. So the Devils, for the first time tonight, not getting that great field position, Robert.
No, I mean, he should have let that punt roll out of bounds. I mean, if I saw that, I wouldn't, like, he couldn't.
As this will bring up another set of downs for the Burlington Red Devils. Once tonight, the Devils have been successful, as we saw a great touchdown for Burlington, as they'll try to replicate that success here. They do not want to go into an unfortunate turnover, as they did turn over on downs in the Marauders' territory, as Bonfilio airs out a pass on the right side. Caught miraculously by the Red Devils by, I believe, number...
I call that play a rocket play, Joe, because you know why? He found the guy open, he knew where he had to throw it, and it was a first down.
Yeah. as that was Pat O'Halloran, the tight end, on the catch. As looks like he was in double coverage, yet still escapes. As that is Zachary Sear, who takes it up the middle and gets the ball 5 or 6 yards on the carry. And Sear, trying to show his running moves, punches it past the 30-yard line. For the Devils, the third time tonight in the Marauders' territory, so this Belmont team not too great on defense, as the Devils will try to test themselves yet again. Gianni Newman lined up on the left side with Pat O'Halloran. The Devils in the backfield takes a snap. Bonfilio, as the pocket collapses, takes it himself, going out of bounds as he runs out. I think he picks up the first down for the Red Devils.
Joe,
yes, indeed, as they pick up a first down on the carry by the keeper.
Joe, I absolutely loved that play. He didn't find anybody open. He scrambled, and he got a first down and more.
And Bonfilio saw that the pocket was collapsing. His offensive lineman couldn't hold them back, so he took it himself, was fearless, and got the first down for the Red Devils. As Burlington in the I formation, shuffle pass over to Sear on the right side. As Sear is brought down for no gain, second down for the Red Devils on the 29-yard line.
Joe, let's see what they can do on a second and 10. Is he going to throw? Is he going to run it? We'll see.
As Bonfilio takes it in the I formation, gives a handoff to Sear up the middle, and Sear is brought down as he picks up 3 yards on the carry. So Burlington trying to test their run game so far in the last few plays, picking up barely no yardage there, as it's going to bring up a 3rd and 7.
Joe, they're giving the defense too many options. I mean, you gotta let the offense choose a play. Like, sometimes you may do an audible, but the defense is getting too many options, and that's why they're having a third down.
As that is the end of the first quarter, we'll see you at the start of the second quarter. I'm Joe Vicioni
with Robert Paris.
And we'll see you then. Welcome back to Harris Field. I'm Joe Vicioni with Robert Paris, and the Burlington Red Devils second quarter is underway against the Belmont Marauders. Burlington lined up in the Wildcat with Bonfilio takes the pressure, throws a bullet over to Fernando Lamin as the pass is just dropped incomplete. As Burlington will have to go for a third down completion. The pass was intended for Gianni Newman as he dropped it, bringing up a fourth down for the Red Devils. Another tough fourth and long for the Red Devils, second in the game as we saw them last time go for it. As Fernando Amin comes on the field off the bench, Burlington lined up in the Wildcat with, excuse me, not the Wildcat, as we see Pat O'Halloran go out to the left side for the Red Devils. Burlington in the trips formation now. And I'll tell you, a bit of communication for the Red Devils. I couldn't even keep up with it, what their strategy was there, as they were trying to get organized for this 4th and 10, not trying to turn it over, Robert, yet again.
Yeah, I don't know if they're going to try to go for a field goal or they're going to go for it. I don't know if they're going to go for a field goal or they're going to try to go for it on 4th down. But it's critical. It's very critical. Let's see what they can do.
As both teams come back onto the field, we're set for a tough 4th and 5 for the Red Devils. The Billy Pappas set up with Bonfilio, as there's three receivers on the left, one on the right in the trips formation. As the Marauders are planning on rushing three, set up in a man-to-man. As Bonfilio, as he fumbled it, takes it himself, throws it, and airs it just over to Zachary Sear, incomplete. So a fumble snap by Bonfilio, and an unfortunate pass that goes out of bounds, as that was honestly just, I don't even know what to say, Robert.
Bonfilio, it wasn't a good play. I mean, if he fumbled it and the defense got the ball, it would have been a turnover on downs. But he recovered it and he threw it to the player and it was completely missed.
Well, I'll tell you, Robert, it's still a turnover on downs, but regardless of the play, the Red Devils bring up their defense back onto the field, but Bonfilio fumbles that, picks it up, and throws an incomplete pass to Sear, who was wide open. He easily could have got in for a touchdown as the pass is aired out to Cristoforo. As that brings up an incomplete pass.
Very good coverage on that play.
As that was Hakeem Managerian, the cornerback, in the coverage. Interesting to see, as it is Julian Otava playing a safety role, at least on that play, for the Red Devils. Good to see number 12 back in, and Alec Rollins, who set up, almost set to blitz here, as the Red Devils are going to rush many here, as it's a handoff to the left side as he gets through a pile, and he is tackled just at the end by the Red Devils. Tackle made by Alec Rollins, the safety, speaking of him, as that brings up that Belmont first down.
They tricked the defense there, Joe. They tricked the defense, and they thought it was a pass, but it was unfortunately a run.
So Belmont, with a great run, they found a hole through the Burlington defense and picked up a first down. As Cristoforo has it looking right, as the pass is incomplete, intended for number 83 on the offense. As the pass was intended for Edwards, number 83. Cristoforo airing out another pass, which is, he definitely has quite an arm, as he has yet to show much of it in this game. Just 1 minute into the second quarter, and the Devils are already up 8-7 after a touchdown by the Red Devils earlier, as that was the Maurauders on the carry as he picks up 4 yards. Billy Pappas, number 44, on the carry. No, excuse me, on the tackle. Wrong side of football.
It's 3rd and 5 again, Joe.
As we'll see what they can do here, Robert. The Maurauders lined up in the I formation. We got a timeout. Is this going to be a timeout for Belmont? So Belmont takes a 30-second timeout, as I'm not sure they were anticipating a blitz by Burlington, as that was what they were planning on doing. So they take it their first timeout. Each team's with 2 timeouts remaining in the half. Belmont with 1 receiver on each side. Burlington set up for a blitz. A handoff is given straight up the middle as he is brought down, and it will be close, as it's a first down for the Maurauders, and the Burlington Red Devils cannot defend the run on that play.
Again, as I say, they got tricked. They thought it was going to be a pass. It was a run.
And I'll tell you, Billy Pappas looking like a very small man on the field. That was Pat O'Halloran towering over him, looking almost like 2 feet above him. As Burlington set up playing zone right now, as Cristoforo throws a deep pass, as it is run down by the Red Devils with great coverage.
That was completely great coverage, Joe. You see, he covered him well, and if he keeps covering him well, they might win this game.
As that was a great deflection by number 12, Alec Rollins. That's a nice welcome back for him. As that pass was aired out and easily could have been a first down and maybe caught at about the 30-yard line. But Alec Rollins gets the stop for the Burlington Red Devils. Julian Otavo on the right side playing a cornerback right now as the handoff is given up the left as he is brought down. Big hit delivered by Kyle Forster, who's known for that. Could have been even larger if he got a bit more time on that one. Julian Otavo also combining for the stop.
The Red Devils gave up too much of a too much of a hole there, Joe. And with that, it gave up another. It's a third and four now. Let's see what they can do.
As the Red Devils are rushing three. As Cristofori levels the pass out as to number 34, as that will be a first down.
Joe, I'm sorry, but no one was covering him. They need to cover him. You got to cover him to make a great play. You want to stop them? Cover them.
As that was number 34, Benjamin Jones, the senior, on the catch, picking up a first down for the Marauders. As it's a very cold Friday night here in Belmont, Massachusetts, as the Burlington Red Devils are set to playing a game against the Belmont Marauders, as the snap is given to number 7 as he is tackled down for about 4 yards on the carry. That was Tyler Reynolds on the carry. As Cristofori has been jogging back and forth on and off the field, talking to his coach, trying to set up a play. As this team is scoreless, both teams in fact are scoreless since the first half. Set up in the I formation, two receivers to the left, one to the right. It's a play action pass. As Cristofori looking for 7, as that pass is intercepted by the Red Devils, as Burlington shows a great defensive effort.
Joe,
as that is number 12, Alec Rollins, with the interception on the safety play.
Joe, that was a great play. He followed him, and he caught the pass. He followed him, he caught the pass. He read the play well. Let's see what Burlington can do.
So Burlington with a great defensive stop, as they will now take it at about the 15-yard line, stopping any momentum that the Marauders had in this game. Bonfilio set with his offense on the field for another try at this. High snap, takes it on the left side himself, cutting in and out, and is brought down for about a gain of maybe 2 yards.
That was a great run, Joe. We all see Dylan Bonfilio can run like a bullet. I know that makes no sense, but let's see what he can do.
As we'll see what Dylan Bonfilio can do yet again, his running capabilities are fantastic. As Burlington pushes out three receivers to the right, including the small man, Billy Pappas, as we haven't seen too much of him on the offensive end today. Bonfilio has Zachary Sear to his right, the junior. As he is only a junior, we'll see much out of him more. But here's Bonfilio taking it himself, Robert, as he picks up the first down for the Red Devils.
Wow. Joe, all I got to say is wow. He's saving himself. He's picking it up. He's getting downs. Now, let's see what he can do.
Well, I'll tell you, Robert, if you're going to say wow to that, there's going to be much room for more in this game, because if you know one man, Zachary Sear, he is fantastic. He makes Bonfilio's running look like nothing. And we could see a big run from him or Kyle Forster tonight. So I'd save your wows for later in this game, as Bonfilio takes it, looking pressured, throws it over to Sear, as Sear is brought down. So Bonfilio pressure, throws it to Sear. Would have been better if he just tossed the ball for an incomplete pass, as the Red Devils lose about 8 yards with the completion. Not smart decision making for the Red Devils. If you're just tuning in now, the Burlington Red Devils are up 8-7 with about 6 minutes remaining in this game here at Harris Field. Bonfilio airs the pass out to Pat O'Halloran as he just drops the pass. As he had butterfingers there. As that will bring up a third down for the Red Devils offense.
Third down, critical. I always say it's a critical third down.
Especially given the field position, Robert, as the Red Devils will need to capitalize here. A punt could mean good yardage for the other team, as Bonfilio is pressured, has his time, escaping, scrambling, as it looks like he might take it himself. as he takes it up the right side and just gets in for the first down. What did I tell you, Robert? Save that wall for later. And Bonfilio picks up a first down. What an incredible scramble.
That was an incredible scramble, Joe. The line was good. They held well. He couldn't find anybody. He ran it himself. First down.
I wouldn't say the line held well because Bonfilio was running from side to side without knowing where he was going to go, but it was just the strength and speed of Dylan Bonfilio to pick up the first down for the Devils, providing more hope for this team as they are up 8-7. An away game as the Red Devils coming into this with three straight victories. As Burlington takes a 30-second timeout to get the hang of things after that fantastic tip play by the quarterback.
It was a fantastic play, Joe. Again, I'm going to say it. He can run. He can run really well. And it still stuns me how he can do it. How does he do it?
Now, with only about 5 minutes left here, it'll be interesting to see how Burlington can do. As the Red Devils jog back onto the field. And I'll tell you, the only group that's more annoying than this band that is playing loudly over the microphones is nobody. I'll tell you that at this point, as they're clearly crowding our airwaves. As the Red Devils set, three receivers to the left. As the snap is given, thrown behind him to Billy Pappas. He picks up about 4 yards. Excuse me, Zachary Sear picking up 4 yards on the pass. As he finally catches a pass, as he did not have grease on his hands, as the Marauders send in an extra linebacker and have 45 rush off the field. I've never seen a lineman move like that before. Bonfilio has it, is pressured, looking, escapes himself, and is brought down. So, Robert, if you're Dylan Bonfilio, you should have aired out that pass, because you do take a risk when you scramble it yourself, and we saw it that time.
Yeah, if you...
Bonfilio could have took that and aired out a pass, but instead he got cocky, thought he'd go for picking up more yards, but just didn't get it.
Yeah, I agree with you there. He couldn't find anybody open. As he said, he became cocky, and they tackled him.
As we'll see with the Red Devils, doing another tough 3rd-and-9 situation. Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Bonfilio takes it all the way back and has to throw the pass out of bounds. Not sure what he was doing there. And this time, the Red Devils will get set to most likely punt. So Bonfilio scrambles back to about the 35-yard line and just airs a pass out. As no options were available, no one could get open. And that's what you get when you only put three wide receivers out there. You got to expect for them to double each one of them and make sure that the Devils don't get any opportunity to pass it, because you know the threat of Pat O'Halloran, Fernando Lamine, and Julian Otavo on these wide receiver positions. The Devils set to snap it off as Lamine is back there for the kick, as it's all the way over to number 9 as it bounces out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. And Connor Essick was back there.
First and 10 for Belmont. They're not a good field position, Joe. I want to see if the defense can pick it up.
As the Marauders take it back, Christofori, open number 34 as he catches it. Beats Alec Rollins and is in for the touchdown as Burlington blows the man coverage. And that is the touchdown.
That was an incredible
play. His second of the night. Making it 13-8 over the Red Devils.
That was an incredible play by Belmont, Joe. He had the man open. He couldn't catch him. Touchdown, Belmont.
as Jones beats the single coverage by the safety, Alec Rollins, and gets in for the TD, their second of the night, making the score 13-8 as they're set up for an extra point. That is Aiden Cadigan set up for the extra point as it's nearly blocked as it goes easily through the uprights. I'd say he could get about 30 more yards on that and that would go straight through. As that makes it 14-8 with about 3:45 remaining in the quarter and half after a fantastic touchdown by Benjamin Jones on a pass from Cristofori. Robert, what was your thoughts on that last play?
Touchdown. I thought it was going to be a pick six. He got it, and he ran all the way, and he got a touchdown.
Pick six?
Yeah, the Mayos covered him, and he ran all the way.
Pick six means an interception touchdown, so maybe a bit of confusion there, Robert, but nonetheless, he gets in for the touchdown, making the score 14-8 for the home team, and tries to lift the crowds as there's mostly red in here, as the Devils have a great crowd supporting them, trying to get on their quest for 500 as they're 4-5 on the season. A W here would make them an even 5-5 as they would win in their last four of five games. Cadigan with the kick as he squibs it, as it is tapped by Burlington, as dropped yet again, and Zachary Sears to jump on top of it at the 24-yard line. Greasy hands for the Red Devils for the second time tonight. As it boggled off from one player, yet to another, and Zachary Sears has to jump on top of it.
Zachary Sear, yeah, he had to jump on top of it. And if they didn't recover it, Belmont could have got a touchdown if they recovered.
Belmont? I think you mean Belmont.
Yeah.
As the Red Devils have it here, I formation handoff given to Sear as he picks up about a yard on the carry, maybe. So Sear, not a big game for him, as this Belmont team is great at stopping the run, but their secondary is not that great, as the Burlington Red Devils are yet to test it so far. .34 in coverage, who just scored the touchdown for the Devils. As Sear has it, Sear getting it on the outside line, takes a hit, taking a beating, and is brought down by a plethora of Belmont players as he picks up about 5 yards on the carry.
The Belmont players seem to be frustrated, Joe. And with that frustration, it's going to make Burlington become more confident in their game plan.
As Burlington gives the handoff to Billy Pappas, as Pappas is short of the first down. As it will be an interesting situation for the Red Devils with fourth and short. It will be a first down for the Red Devils after the referees measure it out. As Gianni Newman jogs onto the field, as we'll see if he can actually catch a pass today. Devils set, Bonfilio under center. Gives a pass over to Sear, but he breaks the tackle. Still on his feet and is brought down for about a 9-yard gain, but we have a flag thrown. The Sear made the grab. Referee's set to make their call. As we have a face mask against Belmont, as that will be a first down for the Red Devils automatically, 15-yard penalty. So Belmont, Robert, commits their first penalty of the game, And an unfortunate one, putting Burlington in great field position.
It puts them in excellent field position, Joe. If they can throw this, they could probably get a touchdown, but you never know what Burlington's going to do.
Burlington has it on the 41-yard line of Belmont with still a couple of timeouts remaining as the clock continues to tick down with about a minute 40. Bonfilio, high snap, looking for an open man, throws it for Zachary Sear as the pass is just knocked down by number 34 in coverage. As that pass was just overthrown, but that was Benjamin Jones with a great deflection.
Yeah, it was a great deflection, Joe. But I believe that could have been a flag, because I saw a little bit of holding there.
Where, Robert?
I saw Belmont's defender. He was holding a little bit, so I'm going to say that should have been a flag. That's my opinion.
I disagree with you there, Robert. I didn't see too much of a pass interference there. You got to see a bit more contact, and the referees certainly agree with me there, as it wasn't too obvious. Bonfilio has it in the shotgun, takes the high snap. As he's pressured, avoids a tackle, has to throw a pass as it is boggled, dropped again by Billy Pappas as Burlington keeps dropping passes, bringing up a third down. As it's going to be a third and ten for the Red Devils on the 41-yard line. Maybe it's
41-yard line.
Maybe it's the cold, maybe it's the away crowd, but I'll tell you, the Devils are certainly shaken up right now, at least in the second quarter, as Bonfilio has it. Airs over the pass to the left side for Fernando Amin as he drops the pass himself, as that was deflected by the Marauders. As Bonfilio is airing out some great passes, but it just keeps being deflected by this Belmont defense.
Yeah, but there's a flag on the play, Joe, so who could be on, Burlington or Belmont?
So we got a flag, because it looks like it will be a pass interference. This is going to be against the Burlington Red Devils. As it's a Burlington equipment penalty, I don't know what that is, but the Red Devils will have a third down yet again, so I guess it's sort of beneficial for them. Third or fourth down, a bit of miscommunication on the scoreboard and sideline. Just a minute left in this game. The Red Devils are trying to get a score before this half expires. Across the field, you see about seven fans. A very small fan section with the Burlington cheerleaders trying to give a spark to this game, but we can barely see them, so I don't think they're doing anything. That's right, it is a fourth down, as there was a bit of miscommunication. I'll tell you, I've never seen number 77 run off that field so frantically. Must have thought there was a cheeseburger at the end. As that's a timeout taken by the Red Devils.
Yeah, timeout taken by the Red Devils. All this communication is kind of confusing everybody. It's confusing the offense, it's confusing the defense. I mean, what's going on out there?
As we'll see what the Devils are going to do here. They might go for a fourth down conversion, but the risk is if that does fail, it will give the Marauders great field position as they could air out a couple more passes, maybe to Benjamin Jones, who has two touchdown receptions on the game, as it could be a big game for him. So the Devils have to be risky with their chances. As Burlington is gonna go for a punt here. Fernando Lamine set to punt in the backfield for the Red Devils. Low snap and the kick is up. A beautiful punt high in the air as it is a touchback. So they'll bring it out to the 20-yard line for the Marauders with about a minute 10 remaining in the second quarter.
20-yard line, minute left. I want to see what they can do, Joe. Let's see if they can stop them. If they can stop them, it'd be a great move.
Hopefully Burlington's defense could come up with a stop, Robert. And that would be a fantastic play and a confidence booster for this Red Devils team, as they will need going into halftime. Because when you think of this, the Red Devils scored to make it 8-0 first and then gave up two straight touchdowns to the Marauders unanswered. So we'll see if the Devils can stop here. As we'll see the Marauders air out a couple deep passes in this game. Chris DeFore under center in the I formation as he is brought down by the Red Devils. Kyle Forster on the tackle for Burlington.
Did you see that blitz, Joe? They read it, they tackled him.
Indeed, Robert, and it was a fantastic play by the Red Devils as the clock stops, I believe, for a timeout. As both teams having a bit of communication with about a minute left. I formation. Chris DeFore takes the snap, looking as he is pressured by Sear, and he runs out of bounds to stop the clock.
Couldn't find anyone open, Joe. He scrambled, ran out of bounds. They almost tackled him. And with that, it's a third down play. Really good for Burlington defense.
As the Red Devils defense needs to do something here to prevent the Marauders from scoring, as this will be probably their last chance before they might get set to punt. Belmont with the ball. Chris DeFore under center takes the snap on a pass, looking deep as 85 escapes with the pass is just overthrown to make it incomplete. So the special teams unit will jog on the field for the Marauders.
We're good. 49 seconds left. You know what that means, Joe? Burlington may have a chance.
Maybe they will indeed, as Hakeem Manajarian and Zach Sear in the backfield getting set to return this kick. Hopefully they don't fumble it on the catch, as it's a bit of a squib over to Anajarian as he catches it this time and takes it around the left side. Anajarian trying to show off his basketball moves with that agility.
This is some great field position for the Burlington offense.
As he's brought down at about the 36-yard line. And Najarian showing off some of his agility as the Red Devils have it with about 36 seconds remaining with two timeouts on their hands. Bonfilio takes it in the shotgun as he is pressured, nearly sacked, and he is brought down by Belmont. As Burlington takes a timeout with 24 seconds remaining, as they have one remaining. So Burlington's offensive line cannot stop the pass rush there. And the Red Devils get sacked.
Yeah, Joe, that really wasn't a good play. They lost a couple yards there. Now they're going to have to try a pass play. And with that, I want to see what Burlington Red Devils can do.
What can they do?
Well, they could do either option. They could do a play action. They could do a Hail Mary. They could do a shotgun pass. Now, they want
to... As we could see a Hail Mary pass for the Red Devils here, trying to get in for a touchdown, as we saw quite a bit of that in the Melrose game when the Red Devils faced off against them at home. It was a touchdown pass for Melrose at the end of the game as Bonfilio steps back pretty far as he gives it to Zachary Sear. Sear trying to take space on the right side, and he is brought down as he could not escape out of bounds, as the Red Devils will most likely be forced to take a timeout. And they will, with about 7 seconds remaining in the quarter. Last time out for the Red Devils.
Timeout, Burlington. Third and eight.
As this will be Burlington's last chance of the half, as they're down 14-8 on a frigid night here in Belmont, Massachusetts, where the moon is full. A crystal clear night. Maybe we'll see number 77 rush off the field again like there's a cheeseburger on the sideline.
Better some fries with that?
Maybe a shake too. As like I've said, I've never seen a big man run that much. At least in football. As Burlington's offense jogs onto the field with their tattered offensive line, who has not done too much for them tonight, who has undergone many injuries so far. As Bonfilio with the ball for the last play, as they go for a Hail Mary, as the pass is for Sear. As Sear is, the pass is deflected in the end zone by the Marauders, as the score is 14-8 in favor of Belmont at the end of the half. As Burlington is down by 6, I'm Joe Vicioni with...
I'm Robert Paris.
And we'll see you at the start of the second half. Welcome back to the start of the second half here at Harris Field. I'm Joe Vicioni with Robert Paris, as the Burlington Red Devils are set to kick off to the Belmont Marauders. Fernando Amin is set to kick it off. Burlington currently down 14-8 after scoring the first touchdown to start out the game. After that, they gave up 2 consecutive touchdowns. As they will try to get back in this game, Lameen with a direct line drive kick to the 10-yard line, taken back by Belmont. Belmont with a bit of momentum and is knocked hard out of bounds at the 32-yard line.
Yeah, knocked out of bounds. What does Burlington need to do? Well, here's what they need to do, Joe. They need to step up. Maybe they talked in the locker room. They need to do some more blitzes. They need to cover more men. I want to see what they can do in the second half. They had halftime. Now pick it up.
And I'll tell you, Robert, that score prediction of 20-0 is certainly out the door.
Definitely out the door.
As we'll see what the Red Devils defense can do right here. Maybe try to pick up some momentum. As the snap is handed over, and he is brought down by the Red Devils. That is Cody Davidson on the tackle. So the Red Devils are with a key defensive stop, making Belmont lose 4 yards.
As I said before, yeah, the try new plays, blitzes. That's what they got to do. Keep going, keep going. That's all you do, make a stop.
I agree with you, Robert. Burlington needs to pressure the quarterback, as they did not do enough of that in the first half, as it looks like they're only rushing 3. Another linebacker steps in, as that's a handoff to the right sideline by the Marauders, but he's brought down by, I believe, Zachary Sear on the tackle, as he picks up about 4 yards. It's going to bring up a 3rd and 11.
Third and 11. This is the Burlington defense is getting very, very aggressive. I love it. I love why they're doing it, because they're making the other team nervous.
I wouldn't say that yet, Robert, but their defense is certainly looking good. But we'll see how the Red Devils can hold up with this field position, if their defense can do enough The Devils set to rush three on the pass attack as Kyle Forrester sets in for the blitz. Handoff as it's a play-action pass. Cristofori lines it over to number seven as it's incomplete. Coverage by Alec Rollins, and that will be a fourth down as the Marauders will be forced to punt.
Excellent play by the Burlington defense, an excellent drive. They got aggressive, they went to the locker room. They said, what can we do to stop this team? Well, you just did it.
And the Red Devils will need a big return here too from either Zachary Sear or Hakeem Anajarian. Both players kind of out of the mix right now for MVP of the game, but certainly they can change that as Hakeem Anajarian blew a coverage earlier that led to a touchdown. And Zachary Sear, unfortunately, hasn't had too big of a running game as the kick is up to Hakeem Anajarian where it takes a bounce. It fumbles around, but he still gets to it at about the 29-yard line. So, Robert, Hakeem Anajarian just didn't have enough awareness on that play. It bounces around and nearly ends up in the defensive, in the Marauders' hands.
Yeah, I mean, he tried to get it, and he did get it. I mean, he has to be more aware of the ball where it is. If he keeps going, then he's going to get a wrong, bad play.
Try to save it.
Hakeem Anajarian. He has to do better. He has to do better because he can't let that happen.
As Burlington lined up in the trips formation, three receivers on the left. Bonfilio high snap, ball goes as he fumbles the ball, and the Marauders take it over at the 25-yard line. So Burlington slippery with the hands, causes a fumble, maybe a bit of a miscommunication, as Bonfilio lost control over the football, setting up the Marauders in beautiful field position. And I'll tell you, Robert, that is certainly a shame after a great defensive stop by the Red Devils and a near great offensive possession for them as well.
I'm going to have to say, Joe, that was a horrible play. He dropped the ball, he fumbled it. Unfortunately for the offense, they got to go back to the sidelines and watch the defense do their job.
As it's a handoff taken straight up the middle, as he's going to pick up 4 yards on the carry, maybe. Billy Pappas on the tackle as the Marauders are trying to get in for another touchdown, which would be the first of the second half, as it's currently just about 2 minutes into the game. Excuse me, second half. The Marauders set up in the I formation, two receivers to the right, one to the left. As Cristofori gives the handoff up the middle again, but he is brought down by a combination of Billy Pappas and Cody Davidson.
Billy Pappas and Cody Davidson, great players. They read the play right, they tackled them. Now it's going to be third and six.
As he picks up 1 or 2 yards on the carry, and Burlington will have to defend against another third down. So far, Burlington's defense has been phenomenal as they stopped the Marauders once back on the other side of the field, as they'll have to try to do it again in the red zone. Cristofori, looking at his options, takes his time, pressured, airs out a deep pass as it's nearly caught and incomplete. So that will bring up a fourth and six for Belmont. As number three, Cadigan, their kicker, will check in. As I believe the Marauders will set up for a field goal, one of the first that I've seen this year. I think the last time I saw a field goal was in the Melrose game, as kickers on high school level are not known for their consistency, as this is certainly a far field goal, as it's going to be about 39 yards. Very impressive if he can make this. As the kick is up, squibbed, and I believe it is no good as he chipped it. Looks like Cadigan got the wrong part of his foot as Burlington will take over at about the 30-yard line.
That was a good drive by the Burlington defense, Joe. I really think they can stop this offense, and they did. This is the second time they did it. They tried a field goal attempt. He didn't make it. Let's see what the offense can do.
Yes, indeed. As we'll see what Dylan Bonfilio and his squad can do right here. Bonfilio, Billy Pappas, and Zachary Sear in the backfield yet again together, as we have Pat O'Halloran on the left side, on the right side, Fernando Amin and Gianni Newman. Burlington I formation, handoff given to Zachary Sear. He is brought down as he loses a couple of yards on that carry. Read easily by the Marauders.
The Belmont defense is getting very aggressive as well, Joe. You can see that they're getting very aggressive, and this means that Burlington is getting under fire.
As the Marauders will bring up an offensive play. Excuse me, not Marauders. As the Red Devils will have a 2nd and 10 on the 22-yard line. Bonfilio pressured, gives it over to the left side, incomplete for Gianni, intended for Gianni Newman. Bit of a late hit by number 34, Jones. Nonetheless, it's going to bring up a 3rd and 10 for the Red Devils to have to deal with.
Critical third down, Joe. The Burlington offense has to get a first down on this. If they don't, they might have to punt it.
As Bonfilio takes the high snap, nearly boggles it, goes for a deep pass as it is just incomplete. As it was nearly caught by Zachary Sear, but unfortunately, that kick was, unfortunately, I can't talk right now. Unfortunately, that pass by Bonfilio was short, and it will set up Fernando Amin, the kicker, for a punt. And Amin gets a high and short kick as it is dropped down to about the 50-yard line, where the Devils will touch it down, setting up good field position for the Marauders.
Belmont's on the field, Joe. This means the Burlington defense, can they stop them for a third time? I think they can, because they stopped them twice. If they stop them again, they can get the offense back, and they're going to do well. I just have a feeling they're going to do well.
So we'll see what Burlington can, their defense can do here, as they have not had too much of a pass rush today. We'll see if that can change, as they've only been rushing three. As the shovel pass is given to the left side, as he is tackled out of bounds, as that was Jones on the carry. Picking up about 1 or 2 yards maybe for the Red Devils. No, excuse me, for the Marauders.
That wasn't a good play at all. That wasn't a good play at all. The defense, they stopped them. That's a great play. But Belmont, they're trying to make it challenging for the defense. No, they're making it easier.
On Belmont's side of the football, Robert, I sort of agree with you. It was just a shovel pass outside. He had to run out of bounds, but it seems like Burlington really closed off that angle and forced him out of bounds. As Cristofori takes his time, heaves the pass for number 28, as that is caught at about the 42-yard line. He's just short of the first down, as it will bring up a 3rd and about 1.
I can see that Belmont may run this play. They may pass it. They may trick the defense, but the defense may have a plan for this time.
We'll see what Cristofori can do here, what he can get out of his pockets, as it's going to be a 3rd and 1. Hopefully Burlington can stop the Marauders for the third time of the quarter, as Burlington fumbled earlier in this game in the quarter, which was Bonfilio, as Cristofori set up in the I formation, gives the handoff to Jones, as Jones is brought down, but looks like he easily picks up the first down.
That was a great
play. Moves the chains.
That was a great play, Joe, by the Belmont. They moved it in, they got the first down. Burlington has to pick it up.
As we'll see what Burlington's defense can do here, as Belmont is inching closer and closer to the end zone, trying to get another touchdown maybe. before that, we'll have to see what Cristofori, the quarterback, can do as he's set up in the Wildcat formation as he has two running backs next to him. Goes back in the pocket, pressured by Pappas, and throws it over to 45, who is hit down by a combination of Kyle Forrester, Pappas, and O'Halloran, as that will bring up a 2nd and 12 for the Marauders.
Pressured the quarterback. They tried to sack him. They did the blitz, but he threw it. He threw it out of contact. He found a player and he went out of bounds.
A bit of change of personnel on the sideline as number 7 runs in the game for the Marauders. Cadogan, the kicker on the sideline for Belmont, trying to get set up for a field goal, as he might be kicking one yet again. Cristofori, shuffle pass over to Jones on the right, on the left side, as he gets by a defender and is brought down for a gain of maybe 5 or 6 yards.
The defense slacked on that play. Very sloppy, very sloppy. They should have done better. What they could have done was followed the play. They didn't follow the play. First down, Belmont.
Cristofori has the ball in the I formation. I don't know how many more times I'm going to have to announce that tonight, as it's a fullback play, as it's a play action towards number 99, as the ball is just deflected by Hakeem Anajarian on the coverage, as that's an incomplete pass, bringing up a 4th down for Belmont. Pretty obnoxious chant coming from the crowd.
Yeah, can't even myself think, Joe.
Cristofori getting ready to take the snap. Motions as Cristofori is going to call a timeout for himself. Belmont timeout. I believe it's going to be 30 seconds. As a timeout was taken by Cristofori, the quarterback, trying to get his team back in the game. As both teams break out of the huddle, the Marauders bringing up a 4th and 6 as they will go for it. Set up in the eye. Tight end and one receiver on the right is a fake play action pass. As Cristofori takes it himself as he is brought out of bounds. It's going to be close. Just a matter of where it happens. More confusion among the referees on whose possession it will be. As we await the decision. Whoever gains possession, this will be very big, as it will be a 1st down for the Marauders. As Cristofori scrambles and picks it up. Now I'll tell you, that's certainly questionable, as you're not sure where the ball went out of bounds on the carry for Cristofori. Nonetheless, the Red Devils will have to defend against another set of downs for the Marauders. Belmont High giving Burlington all they can handle on this drive. High snap given over to Jones. Jones takes it on the right side, picking up momentum and speed as he is brought down by, I believe, Alec Rollins. And yeah, Alec Rollins at about the 10-yard line. Ryan O'Halloran with the tackle as well.
Choppy play by the Burlington defense there, Joe. Now they got a first down and goal. Not good.
As Burlington has to defend a first and goal on the 8-yard line, which will really be a big test to this defense as they have not been that great so far in the second half and in this quarter, as Ryan O'Halloran comes up with the tackle on Jones, bringing up a second and goal.
That was a great stop by the Burlington defense. Keep the momentum going. I like what they're doing. Stop them here.
Yeah, great stop by Burlington. It really swings around the momentum, but hopefully they can do it yet again, as it's about a second and eight, second and goal. So Burlington will have to do it three more times as it is fourth down territory. As Burlington is certainly put in that hole, down by six, just under 3 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Christofori gives the snap off to number nine, who gets around outside, and he runs it in easily into the end zone, as that's going to be a touchdown, unfortunately, for the Marauders, as celebrations are definitely occurring as we can hear cowbells from the stands, as that makes it 20-8 in favor of the Marauders, as Burlington has allowed three consecutive unanswered touchdowns. Marauders will set up for an extra point.
Well, Joe, my prediction in the beginning of the game, it's going way downhill right now.
As the kick is good for a touchdown, Belmont. Teams are set to kick off. As it's most likely going to be Anajarian and Sear in the backfield. Julian Otavo, we have certainly seen a limited rollout of him, as he has not played too big of a part in the offensive end, as he's been mostly playing a lot of minutes at safety and cornerback this game. So I'm interested to see why that has been. Kanajin set to kick this one off. And it's a squib up the side as usual, given to Pat O'Halloran, as O'Halloran avoids a tackle and is brought down at about the 37-yard line.
Yikes, this is awful field position for the Burlington Red Devils, Joe.
Now I wouldn't say awful, Robert, when you got the ball on the 37-yard line. This is one of the best that the Burlington's had it all night. I mean, compared to one of those Kyle Forrester drives that we saw early in the game, this is great field position considering that we had it once on the 15-yard line in this game. So we'll see what the Red Devils can do here. As for once, we see Kyle Forrester in the backfield, who mostly played a fullback role today. We'll get in as halfback as he, Bonfilio, fumbles the ball, but is able to recover it. So, the center and Bonfilio, a bit of miscommunication in tonight's game.
Miscommunication is right, Joe. They don't really know what to do. And if he fumbles the ball and Belmont gets it, then it's not good.
Burlington set yet again. Snap is high over to Bonfilio as it's given over to Zachary Sears. Sears is brought down as he avoids the tackle, stays on his feet, and gets it to the 45-yard line. Sear nearly brought down by a face mask, but stays up on his feet with a phenomenal play, really showing the athleticism of Zachary Sear, as it's going to bring up about a 3rd and 5.
Zachary Sear has some momentum tonight in this game, Joe. He can run and he can fly like a bullet.
I wouldn't say that much, Robert, as Zachary Sear has played a limited role so far. High snap, Bonfilio scrambles it himself, slides, and easily picks up the first down for the Red Devils, eating in to the Marauders' territory. First and 10 for the Red Devils. It's about a minute remaining in the third quarter. So we got a timeout called. Penalty marker. As it's a false start against the Red Devils. Excuse me, delay a game against the Red Devils. False start is the Red Devils. We'll be stuck with a 1st and 15 after a great run by Bonfilio. Has to take it back 5 yards. Bonfilio takes the snap, is pressured, looking, can't find an open man, heaves it as it is out of bounds, intended for Gianni Newman. We got a penalty marker. As it could be a holding. This is going to be a 15-yard penalty, a holding against Belmont. So this time, Robert, Burlington is not hit with the penalty and picks up a 1st down and even more yards.
Yeah, now this is even more like excellent field position. Like as I said before, I screwed up, but now this is excellent field position. Let's see what they can do.
As the Red Devils will have much room to work with, as this was Belmont's second tough penalty of the game, giving up pretty much in unfortunate circumstances. The Red Devils will try to take advantage. High snap for Bonfilio, looking for a pass as it is thrown just short, incomplete. A late hit by Jones. I thought there was gonna be a penalty there as Paddle Helen is crying for it. Jones, very late hit, pretty dirty.
Joe, that should have been a penalty right there. Don't you agree?
Maybe a bit of a late hit, but it is football, Robert, so I guess they can shrug one or two of those off in a game. Bonfilio with Kyle Forrester in the backfield. Getting set. Forrester to the right of him. Bonfilio looking. There's a pass to Sear, and Sear is brought down for a pickup of 3 yards. Hitting chippy on both sides is number 2 for the Marauders is getting a bit aggravated. It's going to be a 3rd down for the Red Devils as the clock continues to tick down below 20 seconds. That's the end of the third quarter, as the Burlington Red Devils are down 21-8 here at Harris Stadium, where the Belmont Marauders take the lead. We'll see you at the start of the fourth quarter. I'm Joe Vicioni with Robert Paris, and we'll see you then. Welcome back to the start of the fourth quarter, as we waste no time, as Bonfilio and the Red Devils have it on a pass, as that is batted down by number, I believe, 58 on Belmont. The score is currently 21-8 in favor of the home team, Belmont.
The Burlington offense, Joe, is looking very sloppy right now. It's not good.
Offense and defense, Robert, as Their defense could not stop the Marauders from scoring earlier in their offense. The last possession had a crucial, their offense is on the field now and does not look too great. The Red Devils with a fourth down, as they'll take the risk on a fourth and six, which is all they can do at this point, as Bonfilio takes the pass, is pressured, finally gets a bit of a good block, airs it out as it is incomplete as it bounced off the turf. Intended for O'Halloran, and Bonfilio again with bad hands as he could not complete the pass, as it will be a turnover on downs.
Bonfilio was very under pressure there, Joe. Now they're going to have to turn over on downs to the Belmont Marauders.
As Belmont will try to take advantage on this possession yet again on the offensive end of the field. One more score, Robert, I'd say would definitely put this game away for the Marauders. And making it, for instance, 28-8 would make this game almost out of reach for the Red Devils, certainly crushing their hope and the fans. But the game is not over yet as the handoff is given to Jones on the outside. Jones, and he is brought down by Kyle Forrester, as that's a 2-yard gain, maybe. Going to bring up a 2nd and 2 from the 36. Should be 2nd and 8 from the 36-yard line. Not that many yards for Belmont. High formation, and I'll tell you, we've seen that about 100 times today. As it's a handoff given straight up the middle. Big hit by Ryan O'Halloran as he took a beating. As it will be just a 3rd and 2, 3rd and 2 maybe. We'll see what the Red Devils defense can do here.
3rd and 8. They might run it. They might pass it. Who knows?
I'm not looking at you. Looking over you. As the Red Devils set to pressure, Cristofori under center, just waiting out the clock at this point. As Cristofori takes the snap, gives a shovel over to Jones on the left side as he is knocked down, but he will pick up the first down for Belmont.
Not a good stop by the Burlington defense. Not a good stop at all. We are just trying to run this out, Joe.
As Burlington is getting set for another defensive possession. As the handoff is given up the middle as he is brought down by combined tackle by Kyle Forrester and Alec Rollins, but we have a flag on the field.
This flag could possibly be on Burlington.
This is going to be a 15-yard penalty against the Red Devils. As Burlington will have to defend it on their own 33.
Oh,
Cristoforo under center. Is that penalty was just enough time for them to waste down the clock as Jones takes it, going in and out as he is brought down inside the 20-yard line at the 18.
Ooh, what a rush that was, Joe. Just went straight for first and goal.
As Cristofori jogs back onto the field with his team. Burlington might be anticipating a blitz on this play. Trying to get a sack would certainly help this team. Or maybe just an incomplete pass to stop the clock, as the clock is their worst enemy in this moment. Handoff given to Jones as he is brought down for no gain.
Nice stop by the Burlington defense. Offense couldn't find a hole. Burlington defense found them, tackled.
Yeah, great run stuff by the Burlington Red Devils in their front four as they were easily able to get by the offensive line. As number 75, the offensive lineman jogs off the field, sending in another wide receiver for the Marauders. As the handoff is given, number 9 on the outside as he is escaping, as he is finally brought down just inside the 5. As that is just inside the red zone, as Burlington will be forced to defend again for a first and goal of the Marauders. Cristofori set up as Jones is in the backfield along with Estock. Handoff given to Jones as Jones is just short of the touchdown. And that works out perfectly for the Marauders as they get to continue to waste clock. There's just about 5 minutes left in the fourth quarter. The touchdown here will pretty much put the game out of the reach for the Red Devils, as their defense really needs to prove themselves on this fourth down territory. Cristofori snaps it, gives it over to Jones, and Jones is brought down by Burlington. Great tackle by Forrester and Ryan O'Halloran. As that certainly makes Jones jog back to his coach, who is pretty frustrated as well. Making it third and goal, about 4 yards to get into the end zone. A win for this Belmont team would snap their losing streak of 1 and make their record at home 4-1, with their last game coming with a loss against Waltham, as they lost 41-34 in a stunning upset. Waltham not too good this year. It will be a false start against the Red Devils. Excuse me, Waltham actually is very productive this year. So an easy detectable false start. So that will bring up a offsides against the Red Devils 5-yard penalty. Making it still a third down. Just inches closer, so it's only about 3rd and inches. As Cristofori gives it over to Jones. Jones trying to pick up space. Jones avoids a tackle, brought down, and he is in for the touchdown. So Jones's strength and mobility breaks a few tackles and gets in for a touchdown. making it 27-8 as the Red Devils give up four straight unanswered touchdowns on the road to a superior Belmont team.
What an amazing play by the Belmont Maurauders. I know Burlington defense struggled a little bit. They struggled on that drive. The flag threw them off. Now, it's not good.
As Burlington is getting the common road team chills, as they cannot do anything in this second half, and that was an issue for them in the first part of the season, as one of their coaches had a departure and they could not score for their first four games in the first half, as the extra point is nailed by Katagin. But Burlington scoreless yet in the third and fourth quarters, as this game is almost out of reach. In fact, it probably is, as they're down by 18 points, which is a three-score game. As we'll see what the Red Devils do here. As Katagin will get set to kick this one off for Belmont. Belmont High School, if they walk away with this win, will end up 4-6 on the season, closing out their regular season record, as both teams will have a week off until the Thanksgiving game, where Belmont will play Watertown here at Belmont Stadium. Harris Stadium, and the Burlington Red Devils will face off against Lexington High School, as they always do, this time in Lexington. Last year, the Burlington Red Devils beat Lexington, so surely it'll be an interesting game, but Burlington lost many seniors this year. So we'll see how Lexington and that game will fare out, as Lexington is 8-1. Nonetheless, it's a split kick, as it was nearly fumbled by Kyle Forster. Forster, still on his feet, is brought down at about the 34-yard line as he picks up a couple yards on the return. Slippery hands tonight, Robert.
Very slippery. He has to have more control of this ball. Apparently, tonight, he doesn't.
As the Red Devils will have it from their own 36. As we'll see, mostly deep passes for this Red Devils team, as they'll try to keep the dream alive and go for the comeback, which is still possible, but coming further and further out of reach. As it is a fake play, as that is Zachary Sears. He's brought down, not out of bounds, as he picks up 9 yards on the carry. It's going to be a second down for the Red Devils, letting the clock tick down. As the Red Devils certainly don't care much at this point, as the clock is not their friend, and it seems like they're trying to get one TD on the board. The Devils taking all the time they can as Bonfilio airs a pass out to Lamine, but too high, goes right through his fingertips. As that will bring up a 3rd-and-2 for the Red Devils. At least that one stops the clock.
I agree with you, Joe. But the defense is doing well for Belmont, and this time the clock's not their friend for the Red Devils.
As Bonfilio gets the pass, low snap. Looking, heaves a pass over for Zach Sears. Sears makes the as he nearly made the reception, but drops it again, and seems like that's the story. Almost like last year's Patriots. He's a bit of Brandon LaFell on his hand. As I'm pretty sure everyone on this team so far has had a drop today for the Red Devils.
Maybe it's that cold wind tonight, Joe.
Or maybe just the cold weather, Robert. I mean, certainly when you're in this situation, your hands are freezing. It's a tough fought game. You're down by 20 points, and it's an away game. There's a lot of factors that can go into it. So maybe your confidence is just down and you think you can't make that catch. Burlington in the trips gives the handoff over to Sear. Sear easily picks up the first down and more, but is brought down inside the 40-yard line for about a 22-yard carry.
Yeah.
the Devils have it as the clock continues to tick down inside the 3 minute mark. Bonfilio, low snap, nearly fumbled. Gets pressure as the pocket collapses and he rushes it himself. A bit of a fake play, but he is knocked down hard. Jogs up happily and brings up a first down for the Red Devils. 2 minutes remaining.
Great play by the Red Devils. Bonfilio didn't find anybody open. He ran it himself, first down.
As the Red Devils will try to get a touchdown just for respect at this point. Bonfilio takes the snap, looking for an open man, has his time, gives it over to Sear, and Sear is just inside, short of the touchdown on the 4 yard line. Billy Pappas, excuse me, with the catch. So Pappas gets it on the 5 for the Red Devils as they'll try to get a touchdown, their first of the second half. As the wind is chilly at this point, Bonfilio with a lob pass for Lamine as it is out of bounds over his head. It looks like it was a bit of a lob, but just some communication error. As it's gonna be a second and goal for the Red Devils, which stops the clock, making it a minute 44. As I've repeated the clock so many times, it is not Burlington's friend, but this game has, at this point, escaped their grasps. I mean, it would take an absolute miracle, something that I would never seen, to make this game back in reach. As the Red Devils take a timeout. The Devils trying to get it into the end zone. Second and 5. As this game is just coming to a close here at the Belmont campus of the high school at Harris Stadium. As this game started at about 6 o'clock tonight, an early game for both sides.
There we go.
As the Devils have the ball here. Bonfilio has Pappas to his right, three receivers in the trips on the right side, one to the left. Bonfilio looking for Lamine, and he is in for the touchdown for the Red Devils. A bit late, but nonetheless, Bonfilio with his first passing touchdown of the game. And Fernando Lamine continues the streak with his second straight touchdown in a game, as he scored last game versus the Salem Witches, who didn't score that game, as Burlington will go for the two-point conversion. And I'll tell you, this is an odd formation as the ball is being snapped on the right side of the field. As it's given over to Bonfilio. Bonfilio tries to take it himself, and he's in for the two-point conversion, despite nearly being tripped up by Jones. So the Red Devils are now down 28-16, trailing by 12 points, as they will most likely go for an onside kick here. And what other options you have?
Yeah, that was a great drive, the Burlington Red Devils. They're doing on second. If they get it back, they could possibly get a touchdown.
So Burlington will be anticipating a two-point conversion. Oh. The Devils set to kick it. And I'll tell you, it is a very cold night here in Danvers. I'm frozen from head to toe, literally. Fernando Lamine set to kick it at the 35. Excuse me, the 40, 35 for NFL standards. Lamine set one, as Jones is the sole man in the backfield, getting set, but it will most likely be an onsider. As remember, it has to go 10 yards for Burlington to get the recovery. As that's what Lamine will try, as I've seen him practicing it before in warm-ups. Is squibbed to the left side, and I believe that is high. Is he a big hit? Was delivered. Oh, he took a knocker there.
Wow, what a hit. It's like one of those wrestlers getting hit.
I would not want to be him there. Big hit delivered by Forrester. Ouch. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, that was a nasty hit. I saw him flying in the air, but none of the rest of the onside kick did not work out in Burlington's favor. And the Marauders will most likely run out this clock, as we will see many timeouts for the Red Devils, most likely. As the Marauders take it, and Kyle Forrester tackles them for a yard short, as Burlington takes a timeout, as they will have three more after this remaining. Both teams in their huddles at the moment after a timeout by the Red Devils to stop the clock. And I'll tell you, this crowd is definitely packed tonight. Maybe that's just the small bleachers, but nonetheless, both teams certainly had a good amount of fans show out, and I'm surprised the amount of Burlington fans that came out all the way to this game. As Belmont is set for it, as Cristofori gives a toss to the backfield as he hits his own teammate, as he is brought down, and we have a flag called on Jones, as that was a hit after the play ended, so that will most likely be a personal foul on Jones.
You can clearly see that one, Joe.
So that will be a 15-yard penalty. As Burlington takes a 30-second timeout, as they still have four remaining. Teams break their huddles. This is gonna be second in a bunch, I guess. Third down. Thank you. As the handoff is given to Jones, Jones takes it up the middle and more, and is hit down by Julian Otavo. O'Howard in also with the tackle. bringing up a fourth down for the Marauders. So you have a timeout, Burlington. So the Marauders will get set to kick. Hakeem Enajarian and Zachary Sear in the backfield getting set for this. As it appears that the moon looks like it's moving. Josh. As it looks like the moon in the sky is moving. Bit off topic, but I'll tell you, that looks interesting. A bit of a sight to see, I'll tell you what. Maybe to enlighten the mood for the Red Devils. As the punt is up to Hakeem Enajarian, as Enajarian catches it, takes a big hit, and brought down at the 45-yard line.
What a hit that was, Joe.
And I'll tell you, I don't think Hakeem Enajarian had too much of a fair chance, because once he caught that, bam, he was hit.
Yeah, what a hit that was, bam.
I mean, I wouldn't say it was as big as the onside kick hit by Kyle Forrester, but I'll tell you, that was certainly something delivered to Enajarian.
That hit must have been felt like a truck. Been hit by a truck, Joe.
As Bonfilio steps back in the pocket, looking as he's pressured and has to throw the ball out of bounds. It's going to be just about a minute left. And I'll tell you, these past 2 minutes feel like a half an hour, because I bet that's what they have been. Last time I checked the clock, it was 25 minutes. So Bonfilio pressured and has to throw the ball out of bounds yet again, bringing up a third down.
Defense is picking it up. Very aggressive, very aggressive.
As this defense is getting by the offensive line easily, and I'll tell you, this O-line is missing last year's, the Jankowskis, as they were two big trucks in the middle of the field who were great at stopping the run, blocking the pass rush and run rush. As they're certainly missing them today, as Burlington takes another timeout. As Bonfilio has the ball, looking on the left side, throws a bullet pass for Lamine, and Lamine is, to Gianni Newman, as he is brought down and tackled out of bounds. So that will stop the clock. So Burlington gets a first and 10. As the Marauders need a bit of a stop here, but I would not worry. As the Red Devils only have 49 seconds to get it in for about two touchdowns, which would be quite a lot to ask. Bonfilio has the time for Johnny Newman, but it just slips off his hands, a bit of a too high of a pass, as Newman cannot extend to make the grab.
Seems like he has butterfingers, Joe.
Maybe so. I mean, I've been saying that all game long, Robert. And I'll tell you, the amount of drop passes that these wide receivers and tight ends have been having is just astonishing. You'd expect them to catch more. I mean, I know it is high school level, but still, when these passes are right in your hands, you should be able to catch at least a couple.
Exactly.
As the clock stops. As Bonfilio has pressure, as he's going to run it himself, and he is sacked by number 59 on the Maurauders. Letting the clock tick down, Burlington takes a timeout with 30 seconds remaining. I don't even know how many timeouts Burlington has left, to be honest. I mean, it felt like five in the past minute.
Feels like 1,000.
Both teams finally break their huddle. Burlington with 28 seconds to try to get a touchdown. Burlington wide up in the trips on the right side. Bonfilio has his time as the pocket just collapses and the pass is batted down by Benjamin Jones, making it a 4th and 10, 23 seconds remaining.
Jones almost intercepted that. Oof.
I wouldn't say quite an interception, Robert, as Jones deflected it with one hand. You'd need more of an Odell Beckham Jr. grab to try to catch that one. As Bonfilio has it, a bit of time. He's in the open field on the right side. Heaves up a deep pass for Sear as it is caught.
Wow.
Touchdown, Red Devils, making the score 28-21. Red Devils down as we have a fight on the sideline between 45 and 51. A flag is easily thrown. Let's see who this is on. If it's against Burlington, this could negate their touchdown. Both teams walk off to the sideline at this point. A bit of confusion amidst the referees. I believe 51 won't see too much of the daylight for the Red Devils after that call. Twelve seconds left in the game as Burlington got the touchdown, as it's credited on the scoreboard for now, making the score 28-22. And this game is still within grasp of the Red Devils if they can get a two-point conversion to go here, making it 28-24. Maybe somehow get the onside kick to go, and best case scenario, Hail Mary. I'll tell you, that would be quite a game, but there's a good chance that won't happen. The likelihood of something like that happening is very small, but I wouldn't give up just yet, Robert.
No, they're not going to give up just yet. They might have the flag, they have the touchdown, they have to get a two-point conversion, then the onside kick.
As that was Zachary Sear on the touchdown reception, as that was clouded after that fight between Burlington and Belmont, as things were getting pretty chippy. Same two-point conversion that we've seen twice already in the game. As Bonfilio has the ball. He's going to try to take it himself and gets into the end zone for the two-point conversion, making the score 28-24. So Burlington responding with two straight touchdowns as Belmont just has a four-point lead, and it is certain that Burlington will do an onside kick and try to get one more chance to win this ball game. And we might see some timeouts as well, maybe too. As Fernando Amin and his squad getting set to roll onto the field for this onside kick. Now, Robert, what do you think is going to unfold here?
Well, Joe, if they get this onside kick, they can go for a Hail Mary, and if they don't, well, it was a great game.
Is set for this one as he gives an onside kick, and that is easily caught by the Marauders as Belmont will take a knee here with 10 seconds remaining, which will end the game as the clock will tick down. The Belmont Marauders walk away with a victory over the Burlington Red Devils here at Harris Field. This was a tough fought game for both sides. Burlington getting the first score of the game, leading 8-0. Then the Marauders coming right back into it, getting four unanswered touchdowns, missing a field goal. But then Burlington coming back, getting two touchdowns in the last 2 minutes, last 4 minutes, showing how relentless they are and how fantastic their effort can be, and making the score 28-24, which is what it is today, as the Red Devils fall short by four. Robert, this is truly a fantastic game.
It was a very fantastic game. They tried their hardest, they tried their best, and they almost made it.
As the Burlington Red Devils walk away with a loss and end the regular season 4-6 in the loser bracket, the Burlington Red Devils won their two previous games against the Salem Witches and the Arlington Spy Ponders, but unfortunately fall tonight against a too tough team, the Belmont Marauders, as it was truly a great game, and we love to bring it to you, as that is the end of the regular season, Burlington coming out 4-6. We thank you for watching. I'm Joe Vicioni with Robert Paris, and we'll see you at the Thanksgiving game.